We're going to hear from Tilly Adams now. She's 12 years old and she first tested positive for COVID at the end of 2020. So now, 2 years later, she's still living with the effects of the disease.
Yeah, Tilly's one of 71,000 children with long COVID in the UK, but she says she's determined to get back to full health. Lovely to have her here alongside our mum Kelly and Dr. Hillary as well. Tilly, thank you for joining us this morning. So sorry that you're going through this and for such a long time. Can I ask how you're feeling this morning?
All right, just like the same, really, because I'm kind of used to it now.
Okay, so what is a day like in your life, Tilly? How does the long COVID affect you?
Because on the day, we have to plan everything out, because if we do too much that day, the next day my legs will hurt and I'm just tired and just not well, really.
So and do you get to go to school at the moment, Tilly?
Part-time. So Monday, Tuesday, I'm at tutor. Tuesday and Thursday, I'm at tutor.
Okay.
And you can do that from home more easily, can you?
Yeah.
So
and do you miss... I imagine you miss being with your friends, you miss all the life that goes on at school?
I miss it a lot, because that was, like, what I was doing every day, seeing my friends, and now I can't really do that.
So long COVID comes in many forms, doesn't it? How has it affected you? We could see you've got a tube. Is that to support your feeding?
Yeah, because I wasn't eating a lot and my weight went down a lot. So this is just to help me get back.
And you weren't eating because you were struggling to eat, because whenever you tried to digest something, it was very painful, wasn't it?
It was really painful and it was just like, oh, it's hurting too bad, I don't want to eat.
Yeah. And having the tube on all the time, how does that make you feel? Because, of course, you still have to go out and about and it's always there.
Well, you do get a lot of stares, but you kind of put up with it.
People are probably wondering why you've got it.
Yeah.
Oh, Kelly, you know, Tilly can speak for herself, but I'm sure as a mum, you can see that she's putting a brave face on what is an unbelievably ghastly situation. Yeah. I mean, long COVID comes in many forms. There's stories in the papers today saying that actually for a lot of people, within a year, they do make a recovery. But this has been devastating for Tilly, hasn't it?
2 years, yeah. And, all right, she's made some improvements, but not enough. Not enough for her to be back to how she was.
When she originally got COVID, did she get it particularly badly? Was she affected severely?
She wasn't. It was just like a really bad cold. And I didn't even think it was COVID at the time until she lost her sense of taste and smell. And that's when I thought I better get tested. And it came back that she had COVID. And then them symptoms started to go, just like the cold symptoms. She just had cold symptoms. And then within 2 weeks, other symptoms started to develop, mainly with stomach pains and sickness. And really tired, I couldn't get her out of bed.
Hillary, we, for a long time, talked about children not being badly affected by COVID, didn't we? It was part of a whole debate around whether schools should close and then whether they should reopen. And that debate was mainly really thinking about the ability that children had to spread it to others who are very vulnerable. Yet we've seen some 70,000 children with long COVID. Tilly living with the terrible symptoms are not even symptoms that you'd particularly think about. Yeah. People still don't think about stomach problems. What's going on?
That's right. Well, Tilly's doing such a good job raising awareness today.
Yeah.
Thank you, Tilly. And she describes these symptoms, which are not necessarily classic ones. Headache, of course, breathlessness and fatigue, people know about. But anxiety and depression, stomach pains, heart rate can raise, digestive problems. So there's a myriad of symptoms which are varied and come and go. But as you say, over 70,000 children are estimated to be suffering from long COVID, 43,000 of whom have had symptoms for more than a year. So it's data that we're collecting that will help us in the long term find out how to best treat this. But nevertheless, it's there. And I think help at school is the main thing, because this brain fog, which they suffer from, this lack of concentration and memory, can be a real obstacle to learning. Mm. So if schools are aware of it and they have special techniques, and you have homeschooling on a Thursday, don't you, to give you a break, that's all very important in making sure their education doesn't suffer.
Kelly, you and Tilly have both been going to the long COVID clinic and there are more setting up because, of course, originally, you know, it's still
so young,
very
isn't
new, isn't it, Hillary?
It's
still very new. Yeah. What treatments can be offered? What advice have they given you to deal with it?
The advice is to take every day as it comes, and that she has to learn to balance herself. So she has to take rest breaks and whatever she does. Mm-hmm. She has different medications that she tries for her stomach, for sickness, because sickness is one of the main things. She feels sick all the time, so she tried a lot of different sickness tablets. And, yeah, it's just learning to live with the life that she's got now.
It's so hard. I can't imagine, Kelly, from your perspective, because I know that Tilly gets very... Her body gets very painful as
very
well, so
painful.
Even when you just want to give her a big hug and tell her it's going to be OK, you can't hug her.
Especially in the very beginning, because she was very frail, because she went down to just over 3 stone.
Oh.
So if I did touch her, she was in a lot of pain. And she was constantly sleeps.
Yeah. Tired out. So, Tilly, how do you stay positive? Because you come in and you're smiling, and as Dr. Hillary said, it's such an incredible thing that you're doing today, sharing this story, because there'll be lots of people watching this morning saying, that's how I feel, and you know. How do you stay positive? How do you keep smiling?
You kind of just got to remember that you're not in this alone, and also you kind of got to stay positive so everyone, like, all the other people, all the other children that are going through it know that you can get better. And it's just, yeah.
Do you feel like you're getting better? It's slowly, but you are getting better.
Yeah, really slowly, but I know I'm getting better.
What are you desperately waiting to do? Once all of this is gone, what will be the thing that you will really enjoy doing that you haven't been able to do?
Going to school and just doing PE.
Doing PE?
Yeah. What's your favourite bit of PE? What's your favourite sport?
Everything.
Just running
having
around.
The fun and the energy to
mates.
Get stuck in.
Yeah.
Well, look, it's lovely to meet you. I'm so sorry you're going through it, but stay strong, stay positive, because undoubtedly that's having a huge impact. And, Kelly, thank you for coming
in as well. Thank you. Thanks for having us.
Thank you for raising money.
Hills, thank you.